And he talked about physics, of course, a great deal. And there I argued with him a lot because I still had strong resistance to his way of doing things.
His way of doing things now being path integrals primarily.
Yes, I said to him, look, you've got to get the mathematics right, and otherwise it doesn't make any sense. And you've got to have some solid foundation in mathematics. It's all right to draw pictures.
Could I interrupt you?
Yes.
I mean, could you... When were you introduced to path integrals and his way of thinking about quantum mechanics? And maybe you could say a few words about that.
Yes, well, he talked a great deal about path integrals, but he didn't really use them. He was, see, there were two aspects to Feynman. There was the way of doing physics. There was the path integral, which gave him sort of the fundamental view of the physical world that...
Propagators.
Everything... No. Before there were propagators. This is the path integral doesn't have propagators.
Right.
It's simply the path integral simply says that you sum over histories, that the world just does everything it can. There are no laws. There are no rules. You start out with the world in a certain state, and then it does everything it can. Can move in all sorts of directions. All the particles can jiggle around as much as they want. In all possible ways. And then at the end, then there's a certain probability amplitude for finding a particular state in the future. And you find the probability amplitude for that future outcome by simply adding together all the paths. That's it. And that's the recipe. And that makes sense. And then so each path contributes an amplitude, which is just got by integrating the Lagrangian and over the volume. And that was his recipe. He never really used that. Mm-hmm. It was that, but that gave him the physical basis. And then out of that, he concocted these working rules, which were a sort of a crude approximation to the path integral, in which you simply gave each particle a straight line trajectory. Instead of having a real path integral, you just sort of got a schematic approximation to it by having a straight line track for each particle and then joining the tracks together at vertices where they interacted. And then you had propagators telling you how the particles got from one place to another. So in order to get the probability amplitude, then you just added up the propagators. And that was sort of a crude version of a path integral, but it wasn't the same thing.